Hey everybody, this is my blog, Dysfunctional Literacy, and I have a section that I call Literary Glance, and that's where I read a first chapter of a novel, and then I decide whether or not I'm going to continue reading. And in my videos, I sometimes call these first page book reviews, because sometimes you only have to read one page, and you know whether or not you're going to read the book or not. And this is one of those times. I'm talking today about Blindside by James Patterson and some other author. Whenever he has a co-author, I don't even pay attention to the name, because all the books sound alike. And this book, Blindside, I think it's the 12th rough draft in a series of rough drafts about some detective named Michael Bennett. Now, there's detective that James Patterson writes about, Alex Cross, and he writes a bunch of rough drafts about him too. And I don't know the difference between Michael Bennett and Alex Cross, but I think one of them is black. And I hope there are other differences, because race is it's kind of a shallow defining characteristic. I mean, maybe one of those characters is an alcoholic, or maybe one of them is a womanizer, or maybe one of them is a moral person torn by being immersed in an immoral culture. But one difference between Alex Cross and Michael Bennett is at least Alex Cross is a last name that you can use in book titles like Cross My Heart or Crossfire, and there's some unused potential titles like Cross to Bear or Cross-examine, or what, Crosswire, maybe? I don't know. It's tough to put the last name Bennett in a book title in a meaningful way. I refer to James Patterson books as rough drafts because every rough draft of his that I've read has been very, very sloppily written. And I know my own writing could be sloppy too, but, you know, I just write a blog. And James Patterson writes best-selling novels every month, so he should have a higher standard. And I don't even teach a master class. So let's take a look. We've got the first page of Patterson's newest, at least the time I'm doing this video, it's the newest rough draft, Blindside. And this is a typical example of his rough drafts. In this first page of Blindside, Michael Bennett's trying to describe a murder scene, but he sounds like someone who's never actually been to a murder scene. He sounds like a pretender. And just so you know, I've never been to a murder scene either, but I've never written and published a murder scene. So I'm not saying you have to have been at a murder scene to write about one, but you should be able to pretend better than what Bennett or Patterson or the co-author here has done. And just so you know, my comments are in parentheses because these paragraphs are kind of long anyway, which is unusual for some of James Patterson's books, but I think I made them longer by adding commentary. So, all right, these are the first two paragraphs of James Patterson's latest rough draft. I did everything I could to distract Lucille Evans from noticing the bloody footprint. Well, why? I mean, we find out on the next page that somebody that Lucille Evans loves has been murdered. Why would she care about a bloody footstep when there's a corpse of a loved one in the next room? A responding officer had tracked the blood into the hallway. One look at the scene inside and the veteran needed to run into the street. A street? He ran into the street? I didn't blame him one bit. Well, you might not blame him for being grossed out, but you might want to tell him not to run into the street. The forensics people, okay, that's a vague term, were in the small, lazy adjective, two-bedroom apartment on the third floor of this building. Yeah, building, what else would it be? On 146th Street near Willis Avenue. Oh yeah, I know that place. In the Bronx. The scene was so horrendous, lazy adjective, that the local detectives had called me to help, even though it wasn't technically considered part of Manhattan North's homicide's usual territory. Two of the local detectives had lost it. It happens. It's happened to me over the years. I lost it once at the scene of a murdered girl. Her stepfather had bashed her head in for crying because she was hungry. She reminded me of my own Shauna staring up through blood spatters. When I heard her stepfather in the other room talking with detectives, I snapped. Okay, snapped is different from losing it. Like, snapped is getting violent. Losing it's throwing up. Michael said he had lost it, like the other detective had lost it, but he had really snapped, and come on, he should know that. It almost felt like another being. Lazy writing. Possessed me. Okay. How does it almost feel like he'd been possessed? Did he be possessed or he hadn't been possessed? Unless he like intentionally forced the possession away. He exorcised himself. I burst into the room, ready to kill. That's where the room was ready to kill. Only the fact that my partner at the time, Gail Nodding, was as tough as nails. Ugh, lazy writing. And shoved me out the back door had kept me from killing the creep. All right, that's a really poorly written sentence that would have been easy to fix. All right. Oh, man. This is a rough draft. I don't even think it's that good of a rough draft. A decent editor or co-author should have had the guts to tell Patterson to clean up this draft. I mean, I know everyone wants to keep his or her job, and telling James Patterson to be better, it might make you unemployed, but still, come on, you can't let this get published. James Patterson, now, he's probably written some decent books, but if he has, I've never read them. I've never been able to excerpt a James Patterson novel, and then I've never thought, you know, this might actually be a good book. I've glanced at numerous James Patterson rough drafts, and all of them, including Blindside, feel, sound, look like rough drafts. At this point, the only Blindside would be if James Patterson actually puts out a well-written book again. All right, enough about me, in my opinion. What do you think? Is this excerpt from Blindside, is it really well-written and I don't recognize it? And has James Patterson actually written any good books? And if you don't think this is well-written, how would you fix a James Patterson rough draft? Okay, all right, let me know in the comments below. And remember, if you like stuff like this, book commentaries, book reviews, go to my blog, dysfunctionalliteracy.com. And thank you for watching.